rode up in Pennsylvania where I used to live, and like one of the superstitions that I have is like there's like a witch that lives on the road. It's like a superstition that a lot of people that live up there have, and it's like if you go on the road at night and you stop, they're just gonna come get you.
Most common ones were, for instance, needing to wear an evil eye pendant with turquoise in it. Keeps away like the evil eye and the bad luck people will send your way. And another one, if I remember correctly, you have to beware of the animals like roosters and goats, things like that, because that was always rumored to be a form that the devil could take in order to torment humans, spy on them, etc. And also, if the devil did take human form, you'd know if you'd seen him, because as he was leaving, he would leave either rooster tracks or he would leave goat tracks.
Well, I don't really have many now, but I guess as a child, I had the same ones, all of them, you know, the stepping on the crack thing that you hear. Of course, I'm from a small town, so you had all these things like if a turtle bites you, won't let go until thunder strikes. You know, there's lots of them, like say, when I was a child, but since I've got grown up, I believe in God, so I'm not real big in a lot of superstition.
Even to this day, one thing that I always think of is, like, as I'm walking down the sidewalk, I don't like to step on cracks, because it's almost like, I feel like, you know, there's that old riddle about, like, don't step on a crack or you'll break your mother's back. So it's almost like, not that, you know, I know it's not true at all, but it's almost like, just in my mind, it's like cracks are things you don't step on, like, in the sidewalk. So like that, I still follow that.
My superstition is never buy a man a pair of shoes. And never buy a man a watch. If you buy a man a pair of shoes, he'll walk out your life. And if you buy him a watch, time will take away your relationship with that person.
Where'd you hear those superstitions from?
My grandmother told me those superstitions. I think everybody has an older person in their family that tells them all these weird superstitions and stuff, but I think that one is true. But yeah, I live by those.
What made you think it was true?
Because I heard of people buying like watches for their boyfriends and buying like shoes and stuff like that, and it never seemed to last, so I think they just fought out of their life, or like time just took away in their relationship, so I buy them shoes and watches.
I wouldn't necessarily say that it's so much of a superstition as much as just I fall into patterns that I'll get into. Writing sometimes, if I come up with a really good essay or poem or something, I'll just use the same pen again and again and again. Let's see. I have a shirt that I like to sleep in that I, like, whenever I have a really bad night the night before and I, like, didn't get any sleep and I want to make sure that the next night that I definitely get a good night's sleep, I'll make sure that I wear that one shirt to bed.
You know, my biggest superstition is breaking a mirror, because I heard that if you break a mirror, then you'll have 7 years of bad luck, and not to swallow gum because it sticks on your heart. Yeah, and don't get your foot swept up.
Where did you hear those?
My grandma told me about the foot one. Then the other ones, I don't know where I heard those. I heard those from somewhere.
Do you believe in those still?
Yes. Except for the foot one.
What would it take to not make you believe in them anymore?
If I broke a mirror, and then for the next 7 years, like, everything good just start happening to me, then I'd be, oh, well, guess that's not real. But for now,